Hey, it's your bro. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, we're going to be discussing the AND as well as the OR logical operators in C++. Let's get into it. Logical operators allow a program to make a decision based on multiple conditions. So, for example, we can create an if statement with more than one condition. And for this video, we'll be talking about the AND as well as the OR logical operators. Let's begin with the AND logical operator. We can check to see if one condition and some other condition is true. If both conditions are true, as in one and the other one is true, then the entire expression is true. If just one of them is false, then the entire expression is false. So let's create a program where this might be useful then. Let's create a program that will ask for somebody's temperature, and if it falls within a certain range, we will display a message. So let's create a double value so we can store a decimal portion depending on what temperature they type in. And let's just create a variable named temp, short for temperature. And we'll create a prompt to ask for the user's temperature. Enter your temperature. And perhaps we'll put this in Celsius. And then we'll want to assign this variable temp. All right. So then let's create an if statement, and this will display a message if it falls within a certain range. All right, so let's begin with if our temperature is greater than or equal to 35 degrees Celsius, then we'll display a message such as your temperature is normal. All right, but what if somebody's temperature is like 200 degrees Celsius? That's obviously not normal. So we would want this to fall within a certain range. So we can use the AND logical operator to check one more condition. So we can say if temperature is greater than or equal to 35, and temp is perhaps less than or equal to 37.5, then we will display this message. Else, we can do something else, such as display a message like go to the hospital. But I spelled it wrong. Okay, let's run this. Enter your temperature. I have a temperature of 150 degrees Celsius, and it says go to the hospital because that is obviously not normal. So if we want this if statement to execute, it needs to fall within this certain range. This condition has to be true, as well as this condition has to be true. Since we said our temperature is 150 degrees Celsius, this portion is true. It evaluates as true, but this portion evaluated as false because 150 is not less than or equal to 37.5. So in order for us to execute this if statement, it has to have both portions of this expression become true. So let's try it again, but we'll have it fall within this range then. So perhaps my temperature is 36 degrees Celsius, your temperature is normal. And with these AND logical operators, you can add more than one. For example, we can put this portion within its own set of parentheses, and we can check something else, such as temp does not equal zero. I guess it wouldn't really make sense for this example since we're already checking to see if temperature is less than 37.5. But this is one way that you can check a total of three things, or maybe even four things if you add another AND logical operator. But that's basically how the AND logical operator works. You can check to see if one condition and some other condition is true. If just one of them is false, then the entire if statement or entire expression is false then. Let's clear what we have and move on to the OR logical operator. So the OR logical operator is somewhat similar to the AND logical operator, but it will check at least two conditions. If one of the conditions is true and the other is false, then the entire expression is true. The only way that the entire expression will evaluate as false is if both conditions are false then. So let's create another similar example. It's going to be a program that will ask if you have a cough. So let's write a, perhaps let's declare a string variable named cough. All right. And we will ask for a prompt. Do you have a cough? Then we'll write within parentheses like the answer that we expect, like yes or no. All right. And then we will assign the answer to our variable cough, which can hold a string. But I'm forgetting a semicolon. Okay, then let's write an if statement. If, and I think the best way to handle this that uses an OR logical operator is that we can say if our string cough, and we're going to use the at method, and we're going to check to see if the character at position 0, index 0, of our string cough is equal to the character perhaps y. All right, so that means somebody's responding with yes, or maybe a yeah. And then we will say, cout, you are sick. And then let's write an else statement. Else, you are probably fine. All right, so here's a scenario. What if somebody types in a capital Y for when they type in the word yes? Let's try it. All right. So maybe for this first run, let's just type in yes, just to be sure that this is working. All right. Do you have a cough? Yes, you are sick. Now let's type that in again with a capital Y. Yes, all caps. You are probably fine, but that's not what we expected. So why don't we check to see if some other condition is true within our if statement, and we can actually use the OR logical operator, which is two of these vertical bars. And we will also check to see if cough at index 0 equals the capital Y. So as long as one of these conditions is true, then this entire expression is going to evaluate as true. Even if one of these conditions was false, as long as one of them is true, then this entire expression is going to be true then, and we will execute whatever is within the code block of this if statement. So let's try this one more time. Do you have a cough? Then we'll just type in all caps, yes. You are sick, which is what we wanted then. So then just like the AND logical operator, we can check to see if another condition is also true or not. So you can just add another set of these vertical bars if there's one more thing you want to check, so you're not limited to just two. Surprise, we're going to be talking about one more topic, and we've discussed it previously in another lesson, and that is the NOT logical operator. And basically what this operator does is that it will inverse an operand. It will reverse the true or false outcome of an expression. And I know we've talked about this previously, but it would be a good point to touch base with this just because this is technically a logical operator. And if there's anybody new to this channel and they didn't see the previous videos, they'll actually be informed about this now. So let's just touch base with this real quick. So let's create a program that will ask for a user's name, and depending on what they type in, it will either display a welcome message or it will display a message such as you did not enter your name if somebody just skips the prompt. So let's create a string variable named name. All right. And then we'll create a prompt to ask the user for a name. So cout, enter your name. And then we will use the getLine function. And within here, we'll type in cin name. So this is in case somebody types in a first name and a last name. It will actually assign the entire line of input. All right, so we'll use an if statement. And then within the if statement, we'll check to see if our string name is empty. And we'll use the empty method that we learned about. So we'll just type in name.empty. So if the name is empty, they must have skipped it, and we will display a message such as, perhaps we'll yell at the user, you did not enter your name. Frowny face. All right, so then if the name is not empty, then they must have typed in something. So we'll display a message, like a welcome message, that says, welcome whatever the user's name is. All right, so let's try this. And then after this run, we'll try and use the not logical operator in action. So enter your name, I'm just going to hit enter to skip. You did not enter your name, all right? With this program, there's another way to write this, and we can use the not logical operator. So this will basically inverse the operand. If it's false, it's going to flip it to true. If it's true, it's going to flip it to false. So if we place this not logical operator before this name.empty method, if the name is empty and this pops up as true, this is going to flip it to false and the inverse of that too. So if basically our name is not empty, we can actually display this welcome message. So if the name is not empty, we will display our welcome message. Else, the name must be empty then, so we will have our message that says, "You did not enter your name." Let's try this and see if it works just like before. So enter your name. I'm just going to hit enter. You did not enter your name. Let's try it one more time, but let me fix some syntax here. All right. Enter your name. This time I will type in my name and just type in bro, and it says, "Welcome, bro." Well, those are three logical operators that you would find useful, the and, the or, and the not logical operators. I'll post the code that we worked on in the comments down below and pin it to the top if you want to take a look or you'd like a copy for yourself. But yeah, those are how logical operators work in C++. Hey you, if you enjoyed this lesson, then you can help me help you in three easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.